Hello dear students, I am assistant professor Roshali Ahir, and in today's session of fermentation technology part 2nd we are going to learn about the vaccines and vaccine production. So in this credit we are going to learn about the three different types of vaccines, which includes rabies vaccine, polio vaccine and tetanus vaccine. So before moving towards the production of actual vaccine, one should know what are vaccines and how they are developed. So before moving to the topic, we'll just study the introductory part about the vaccines. Now the vaccine, it can be defined as a non-toxic, non-virulent preparation of antigenic material that can be used to induce a long-term humoral as well as cell-mediated human response against the pathogen. In simple word, it is the immunological preparation for the against any particular infections. So we'll just study in simple words the principle of vaccine production. Now a standard manufacturer uses bacteria or the viruses which may be killed or in the live form but in attenuated form for the production of vaccines. For example, if you consider an individual may be exposed to an antigen to induce the formation of antibodies. Kisi bhi person ko antigen ka supply kiya jata hai so that his body will produce antibodies against that antigens, and a type of immunity gained by inducing the antigens and the formation of antibody, it is known as artificial active immunity. Antigen kisi bhi individual ke body mein induce karne ke baad jo antibodies develop hoti hai ya fir immune response develop hota hai, that type of development of immunity or that type of immunity, it is known as artificial active immunity. The material used to induce artificial active immunity is the antigen or the mixture of antigens, which is known as vaccines, or it may also be known as immunogens. And the process of generation of such immune response is known as immunization or commonly known as vaccination. Basically, the term vaccine, it has been derived from the Latin word vaccinus, and this vaccinus meaning is cow in the Latin languages. Generally there are two types of vaccines. It may be live vaccines or the killed vaccine. Now if we consider about live attenuated vaccine, the live attenuated vaccine are made from the organisms which cause that disease. To make a live attenuated vaccine, the disease causing organism is grown under specialized laboratory conditions, which causes to lose the virulence of the or the disease causing properties. Specialized condition ke under us virus ko ya fir bacteria ko grow kiya jata hai, and in that condition the virulence factor or the disease causing factor of that bacteria or the virus is loosed by it, and this attenuation, it can be also obtained by the by using heat supply or by the passage of virus in the foreign host, such as embryonated eggs or the tissue culture techniques. And the cell cultures are required for the viral vaccines. Since the virus can be replicated only inside the cell, so the live cell culture is required for the growth of these viruses. And such live attenuated vaccine means the virulence factor is removed from these bacteria or viruses. And such live attenuated viruses or the bacteria are directly injected into the individual after various treatments, and the antibody generation is done. For example, to produce the Sabin polio vaccine, the polio vaccine, it is the example of live attenuated vaccine, and the attenuation was achieved with high inocula and the rapid passage in the primary monkey kidney cell. These virus, polio virus, was grown inside the monkey kidney cell to generate or the attenuate these viruses, and then these attenuated viruses was used for the development of Sabin polio vaccines. Then the second type is inactivated vaccine. These inactivated vaccines are produced by killing the disease-causing microorganism with the chemicals or the heat. By using different types of chemicals or the heat, the bacteria or the viruses which causes infection are killed, and then they are transformed, and a immunological preparation is prepared, which is used as a vaccine or the inactivated vaccine. Here you can see the different types of pathogens or the cultures used for the production of the vaccine. Here now, it just picturologically or diagrammatically, it just shows the procedure or the flow sheet of the different types of microorganism used for the production of various vaccines. Now, we can use the multiple techniques. Now, for example, any particular culture is there of a specific microorganism which causes XYZ infection. That culture can directly used for the preparation of antigen. Okay, that culture is directly used as an antigen, and then these antigens are purified. After purification of these antigens, the inactivation of the microorganism is done by the various chemical and heat treatment, and these preparation or formulation is used as a vaccine. Then the another way is the cell culture or the microorganism. First, they are inactivated. After inactivation, the directly vaccine can be produced. For example, hepatitis A vaccine can be produced by such technique. And the third type is the organism is first grown under specialized condition, so it will get attenuated. So the attenuation process is carried out. After attenuation, the live attenuated culture is used for the antigen preparation, then purification, and finally the vaccine is prepared. Later, nowadays the genetically modified technique or genetic gene transfer technique is used for the vaccine production. So GMOs or the cloning technique can be used as a seed culture for the production of vaccines. Now, specifically the hepatitis B virus or the HPV vaccine or hepatitis B vaccine can be produced by the gene cloning techniques. Now, as we have discussed earlier, that specifically different vaccines are currently produced by the gene transfer technique or the gene techniques. That is, here the whole virus or the whole bacteria, it is not used for the preparation of
vaccine. Instead of using virus or a bacterium, a single gene is used as a foreign material and it is multiplied by using cloning technique. And it is expressed in the various vectors. Now the expression of vectors are used to make large amount of antigens, and the mostly used expression vectors are bacteria like E. coli or the Escherichia coli, yeast or baculovirus. After the production of the antigens, this process induces the vectors to produce the antigen, which are then purified. एंटीजन प्रोड्यूस होने के बाद उसे क्या किया जाता है, प्यूरिफाइड किया जाता है. एंड दीज प्यूरिफाइड एंटीजन्स दे आर कंबाइंड विद द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ सबस्ट्रेट्स एडजुवेंट्स विच आर सेफ एंड वेरी इफेक्टिव इन टू क्योर द वेरियस इन्फेक्शंस कॉज्ड बाय दैट वायरसेस. फॉर एग्जाम्पल ग्रैडसिला और द Gardasil. This Gardasil is an anti-human papilloma virus vaccine. Papilloma virus causes cervical cancer, and to prevent the risk of cervical cancer, the anti-human papilloma virus vaccine was produced with the help of gene technique, which is known as Gardasil. And currently, hepatitis B vaccine is also produced by this technique. So, our next and very important point is the steps used in the production of different types of vaccines. So, here is the flow sheet of different steps used for the production of vaccines. Now, the sequence of the steps involved during the vaccine production are as follow, which includes the upstream process as well as the downstreaming processes. Now, the first important step is the selecting the strain for vaccine production. It is very important step. That is selection of appropriate strain of disease producing organism and maintenance of that selected strain on the medium so that it will retain the antigenic constituents. उसके antigenic property disturb नहीं होनी चाहिए, इसलिए उसे proper maintain करना भी उतना ही important होता है. So, the first important step is the selection of the appropriate strain for the vaccine production. And it should be checked that these strains should be free of the contaminants. Then, the second step is growing the microorganism. The use of proper production media and maintaining the proper conditions or the optimum conditions of that media is very important for the growth of microorganism. Proper media design kiya jata hai, proper conditions, temperature, pH maintain kiya jata hai, so that our desired strain will grow in proper and adequate amount. Then the third important step is isolation and purification of the microorganism. When the media or the organism is placed inside the media, it grows in proper amount. उसकी proper growth होने के बाद उसका isolation और purification करना important हो जाता है. So the harvesting and washing of cultured cells are important, in which removal of debris are done, other impurities like media constituents, आर रिमूव्ड बाई वेरियस टेक्निक्स लाइक होमोजेनाइजेशन और सेंट्रीफ्यूगेशन और मैकेनिकल शेकिंग. ये सब स्टेप करके हम क्या करते हैं, माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म को आइसोलेट कर लेते हैं. देन द नेक्स्ट स्टेप इज इनएक्टिवेशन ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म. इनएक्टिवेशन इज जनरली कैरिड आउट टू रिमूव द हार्मफुल इफेक्ट्स ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स और दैट दिस इज कॉजिंग एक्टिविटी ऑफ इट्स. आफ्टर इनएक्टिवेशन ऑफ ऑर्गेनिज्म द प्रॉपर फॉर्मुलेशन ऑफ वैक्सीन इज डन बाय एडिंग वेरियस एडजुवेंट्स देन द different types of chemicals so to increase the shelf life of vaccines and then the quality control of the vaccine is done. Now specifically the preparations are made sterile by mild heat treatment or by the use of alcohols or other bactericides. Generally the overheating is avoided during heat treatment to prevent the antigenic components and the sterilization is achieved by heating the preparation at 50 to 60 degrees Celsius for an hour in the water bath which kills the vegetative cells but not the spores. The approximate number of the cell in the standard vaccine preparation it is generally determined by using हीमोसाइटोमीटर. एक बार हमारे सिक्स स्टेप जो है क्वालिटी कंट्रोल वगैरह कंप्लीट हो गई देन द सेल सस्पेंशंस आर सील्ड इन स्मॉल एम्प्यूल्स जस्ट लाइक ट्यूब लाइक स्ट्रक्चर्स एंड स्टोर्ड एट 0 to 5 degrees Celsius बट नॉट इन फ्रीज ड्राइड. दीज एम्प्यूल्स आर देन लेबल्ड बाय वॉल्यूम कॉन्सेंट्रेशन name, shelf life, bacteriostatic agents added and date of manufacture as well as expiration. And after it, the vaccine is completely prepared by using these six different steps and it is marketed. तो अभी हमने देखा कि quality control करते हैं. What exactly done under the quality control is the testing of the product. तो पहले क्या किया जाता है, the sterility check is done to demonstrate that no live microorganism is present inside the product. It gives the proper demonstration that whether any live or harmful microorganism is present or not inside our vaccine. Then the chemistry of vaccine is also checked. Now why there is need of checking the chemistry of vaccine? It is checked because it tells us that whether our product has proper amount of preservatives, then exact pH is adjusted or not, as well as we add different types of adjuvants in it. So to check the exact concentration of our vaccine is very important. So in the quality control, chemistry of vaccine is checked, which demonstrates that the product has correct amount of adjuvants, preservatives and the pH is also correct. Then the next important factor for the quality control is the safety. It is very important that the vaccine given to any particular individual is safe for that person. So to check the safety of the product is very important, which gives that the overdose of that vaccine should also not cause any kind of harm. अगर गलती से वैक्सीन का डोज कम ज़्यादा हो गया पेशेंट को तो उसका कुछ भी हार्मफुल इफेक्ट पेशेंट पर नहीं होना चाहिए. ये सेफ्टी मेजर डेमोन्स्ट्रेट किए जाते हैं अंडर क्वालिटी कंट्रोल. इट डेमोन्स्ट्रेट्स दैट एन ओवरडोज ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट कॉजेस नो हार्म. देन रेसिड्यूअल टॉक्सिसिटी. हियर वी चेक्स दैट whether our product causes any toxic effect or not. So the residual toxicity is used to determine or to demonstrate that the product contains no material that can cause harm. Then the quality control is also done to check the efficacy of the product. So the efficacy, under efficacy, it demonstrates that each antigen in the product meets the recommended guidelines in the internationally recognized test. It should give the proper results, or it should follow all the guideline levels given, set by the standard organizations. So all these tests are carried out under the quality control. Now, see here you can. अभी हमने steps देखे थे कि vaccine कैसे produce किया जाता है. Here in diagrammatic form you can see how the vaccines are produced. तो vaccine produce करने के लिए क्या होता है, हमारा पहला step था the selection of the strain for the production of वैक्सीन. तो हमने देखा था कि हमें अप्रोप्रिएट स्ट्रेन जो डिसीज प्रोड्यूस कर रहा है, दैट सेल वी हैव टू सिलेक्ट. सो फर्स्ट वी प्रिपेयर अ सेल कल्चर. आफ्टर प्रिपरेशन ऑफ द सेल कल्चर, इट इज इनोकुलेटेड इन द प्रॉपर मीडियम. आफ्टर द इनोकुलेशन द वायरस production in the larger amount is carried out. After the production, they are inactivated or the harvested. After harvesting it, these harvested products, they are transferred into particular containers which contains a bulk of antigens in it. तो इस एंटीजेंस को बाद में क्या किया जाता है, प्यूरिफाई किया जाता है. नाउ दिस प्यूरिफिकेशन प्रोसेस इट कैन आइदर बी कैरिड आउट बाय सेंट्रीफ्यूगेशन टेक्निक और बाय सिंपल फिल्ट्रेशन टेक्निक. तो एक बार हमने सेल लिया, सेल को मल्टीप्लाई किया इनोकुलेट करके मीडियम में, जब ज़्यादा अमाउंट में ग्रोथ हो गई, दैट ग्रोथ इज एन हार्वेस्टेड. And this harvested growth is then purified by using centrifugation or filtration technique. After filtering it, the filtrate is taken inside the container, and different types of bulking agents, stabilizers, preservatives, adjuvants are added in it. And a proper formulation of vaccine is carried out. After the proper formulation of vaccine, they are filled in different types of ampoules. Here you can see the different types of ampoules. Here the fillings are done aseptically under proper monitorized conditions inside the ampoules. After filling, a proper inspection of these ampoules is carried out. Then the labeling is done. After labeling, the packaging of these vaccines are carried out, and then these vaccines are marketed. So these are the steps for the production of different types of vaccines. आप यहाँ भी देख सकते हो, it is the simple form. हमने पहले क्या किया, वायरस को सिलेक्ट किया. वायरस को सिलेक्ट करने के बाद में उसके मल्टीपल कॉपीज बना लिए. Now this is the original virus and this is the virus prepared inside the lab. तो ये लैब में जो वायरस बनाया गया था सेल कल्चर यूज करके, इस वायरस में इट डज नॉट कंटेन्स एनी काइंड ऑफ विरुलेंस फैक्टर, इट कांट कॉज इन्फेक्शन. तो हमने सिर्फ क्या किया कि सेल का आउटर जो ओरिजिनल वायरस था उसका आउटर कंपोनेंट लिया, एंड दिस आउटर कंपोनेंट वॉज जस्ट सराउंडिंग आर लैब वायरस.
उसको लेकर हमने फिर उसका क्या किया, मल्टीपल कॉपीज बना लिए। मल्टीपल कॉपीज कैसे बनाए, बाय यूजिंग फर्टिलाइज चिकन एग। आफ्टर इंक्यूबेशन ऑफ 2 to 3 days वी गेट मिलियंस ऑफ वायरसेस एंड दीज वायरसेस आर देन किल्ड प्यूरिफाइड एंड यूज एज अ एंटीजन्स फॉर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ वैक्सीन्स। तो यहाँ तक हमने देखा कि हम वैक्सीन कैसे प्रोड्यूस कर सकते हैं बाय यूजिंग डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ वायरसेस और बैक्टीरिया। नाउ देयर आर आल्सो सम काइंड ऑफ एडिबल वैक्सीन्स। एडिबल वैक्सीन्स दीज आर द जीन्स विच आर एनकोडेड फॉर सिग्निफिकेंट एंटीजन्स विच आर इंट्रोड्यूस इनसाइड द प्लांट सेल। एंटीजन सीधा प्लांट के सेल में या फिर जीन्स में इंट्रोड्यूस किया जाता है सो दैट that plants fruits can produce the vaccine directly। उस plant के fruits में vaccine produce हुआ होता है। जब भी हम वो fruits consume करेंगे हमें directly वो vaccine या फिर antigen मिल जाएगा and our body will be properly immunized। These edible vaccines generally they are under experimental stage। First transgenic or the edible tobacco plant was tobacco। This transgenic tobacco is successfully engineered for the production of edible vaccine। Hepatitis B antigen use करके उसका gene हमने निकाला और उसका gene हम क्या किया गया, that gene of hepatitis B virus was transferred inside the gene of tobacco plant and the optimum level recombinant proteins were obtained from that tobacco plant seeds as well as leaves। बाद में potato plant पर भी ये treatment किया गया। potato plant में cholera cause करने वाले organism का gene potato plant में introduce किया गया and then the potato which is the best source of vaccine it was produced successfully। लेकिन प्रॉब्लम यहाँ ये था कि हम पोटैटो को डायरेक्टली कंज्यूम, रॉ पोटैटो कंज्यूम नहीं कर सकते। इट नीड्स टू बी कुक्ड प्रॉपरली एंड ड्यूरिंग कुकिंग प्रोसेस दिस प्रोटीन और द एंटीजन्स दैट कैन गेट डीनेचर सो दे आर नॉट पैलेटेबल। And here, vaccine for the cholera is successfully developed inside the potato. Then another example of edible vaccine is the banana. Banana is an ideal plant for the oral vaccine production due to its excellent digestibility. वो easily digest हो सकता है. Palatability, मतलब हम directly उसे consume easily कर सकते हैं. अवेलेबिलिटी थ्रू आउट द ईयर, वो पूरे साल में मिल जाता है। सो द वैक्सीन फॉर हेपेटाइटिस बी इज सक्सेसफुली मेड इन द बनाना प्लांट। सो दिस वॉज ऑल अबाउट द एडिबल वैक्सीन्स। नाउ डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ बनाना फ्रूट, टोबैको प्लांट, सोयाबीन कैलस, पोटैटो हेरी रूट्स, पोटैटो माइक्रोट्यूबर्स, टोमेटो फ्रूट्स आर द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ द एडिबल वैक्सीन्स। So this was all about the introductory part about the vaccines. In the next lecture, we will start with the actual production of different types of vaccines. Thank you.